Hi, Silent Moon. Hi, Liz. Look at that one, y'all. Isn't that gorgeous? Good morning. Good morning. Hey. Good morning, everybody. Morning, morning. I'm going to get right into it, y'all, because my time's afternoon there, yeah. Hey, Liz. I'm going to get right to it today, y'all, because my time has been off with walking, so I'm walking slow so I can make sure I get to it. Hi, good morning, Janicia. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, sweetie. Hi, Howard. Hi. There's a helicopter that just passed. This is the place that gets rented a lot. All the homes on Swiss Avenue that I show you every morning, they're private residences, but this one in particular is rentable, and it has people. It's a mansion that has people. People hang out outside there, and they're in their tuxes and in their after five wear. It's absolutely gorgeous. So I thought I'd give y'all a really good, Liz, it's from weddings to cocktail parties to all that. So so y'all, that's what this mansion is. It's one of the only non-residential mansions on Swiss Avenue, and you can't get a good view, but that porch area, that is, people just hang out there and drink on cocktails, and they normally have valet on the side here where you see that little U. There's valet guys that are parking people's cars and whatnot. But let's get to the subject matter, and you'll continue to see the eye candy, of course. So y'all, a success principle I was just talking to someone yesterday about that I wanted to talk to you about is that, y'all know I'm a coach, but I'm also a strategist. And so you use different strategies based on what your goal is. And so if you looked at the subject matter of this particular Periscope, it said the hockey puck principle. And let me explain that to you, what the hockey puck principle is. The hockey puck principle is when Wayne Gretzky, the great hockey player, was headed towards retirement, he was interviewed by Harvard, and they said, if you could boil down your success to one really great principle that has made you the great hockey player that you are, what would you say is that principle? And, you know, and Wayne Gretzky, he thought about it for a second. And for those of you who don't know, Wayne Gretzky is the equivalent of like Michael Jordan in basketball. Wayne Gretzky is an amazing athlete. And he said, well, the one principle I would say that set me apart from all these other great hockey players who have the athletic prowess and all the things they had is that I developed the discipline in myself to not go where the hockey puck was, but always to make myself go to where the hockey puck will be. And so I'll say that again. His principle that led to all his success was that he didn't worry about where the hockey puck was, he worried about where the hockey puck was going to be. And that is a huge principle for when you're going after your goals and the success that you want. It's easy, and I know we all have daily responsibilities where we really need to be mindful of what will get us to our goals as quickly as possible, what goals that we need to set to make our life have meaning. But I say practice the 80-20 principle when it comes to going after your goal and using the hockey puck principle. That means that spend 80% of your time going after what'll get you the results that are more, a little bit more immediate, if you will. But one key to your longevity is that you really need to be thinking about how what you do is you're incorporating where the hockey puck will be. So like one of my friends on here is Liz Smith. I'm gonna use her as an example. Liz Smith is all about destination weddings, right? She's this fabulous destination wedding planner in Florida. Well, guess what? how Liz can incorporate that, and I'm gonna hang out with this one, y'all, because that's so gorgeous. I've never showed y'all this one. How Liz can incorporate this principle is that still working on what she's doing now, but building out her business where she's like what is up and coming in the wedding planning industry that will be lucrative 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years down the line. So again, for those that just joined, the hockey puck principle is that Wayne Gretzky said that the reason why he was able to be so great at what he did is that he didn't, he practiced making himself go to where the hockey puck was going to be, so that before his competitors got there, before they're able to get, he developed a vision and eyesight to know where the hockey puck was being driven to, and he got to that spot before any of his competitors did. And so while everyone's going and following the puck where it is, he went to where it will be. So what the principle that I'm asking you to incorporate in your life, in your business, when you're incorporating your goals, what you want for your family, don't build it based on where you are. Build it based on where it will be. Let me read this question. So maybe we need to find out where the thing. Yes, that's a great way of saying it, Tuesday. I'm sorry, I didn't see your username, but yeah, that's a great way of saying it. And again, even for you black and white thinkers, what I'm saying to you as a strategy is that I understand that we have daily responsibilities, and if you're building to where things will be, it won't have that immediate gratification of getting you immediate money. So what, yes, like a chess player, absolutely. So what I'm telling you is that do the 80-20 principle. Spend 80% of your time doing what will get you to more income that you need to for your responsibilities today, but spend 20% on what will be. And so you do, if you do week in, week out of discipline, because it takes discipline, because you won't see those immediate results, y'all. So take the discipline to say, I'm going to spend 20% of my time per week, day in and day out, on what will be, y'all, before you know it, after a year, after 2 years, while your competitors are scrambling for what will be, you'll already be in the spot like a Wayne Gretzky. You'll be in the spot, you'll be executing and not building it. If that makes sense, give me some hearts. Hearts, hearts, I love hearts. So the last principle that I'll, I'm sorry, not principle, the last thing that I'll tell you about this principle is that if you think about it, I'll use another example for those of you who aren't as enthused about Wayne Gretzky and how great he was at hockey. Another person that a lot of us know about that did the exact same thing, he'd call it differently, is Steve Jobs. Just about every interview Steve Jobs ever did, they always asked him, well, what are you coming out with next? He said that Apple would never have been that great if all he did was create products that customers told him that they wanted. He always built products of what customers didn't even know they needed. So guess what? That's the hockey principle at work. That's him building something that customers, he got to the spot before his competitors. It was Apple that was so groundbreaking and innovative with the iPod, the iPhone, the iPad that we all know and use. He got to the spot and was building it before his competitors, so that by the time that market share was open and people was like, oh my God, this is a cool gadget, the Apple was already in the spot and competitors were scrambling to catch up. So that's another example that you can have kind of in your mind of how lucrative it can be to incorporate this principle. Thank you for joining me, y'all. I hope you enjoyed the eye candy on Swiss Avenue here. And look at this, rebroadcast if you need to, but incorporate the hockey puck principle, because it will lead to your long-term success, because you'll get in the spot before your competitors will. Thank you. Maximize your potential. You deserve it. I believe in you. And join me tomorrow at about the same time, y'all. Thank you so much. And look at the, I'll show you the last view of this gorgeous one here. You bet. Oh, you're welcome. Thank you. Thank you for joining me, y'all. Thank you.